Ravi Khurana versus the state is a classic example of a woman using as a weapon the very law that was made to protect her.
Men's rights activists from across the country have been asking for a change in dowry, domestic violence, and rape-related laws because they're prone to misuse by women. And it's not just them. We all know people who believe that women frequently misuse dowry and rape-related laws because it's a convenient way to extract what they want from the accused and their family. Even the Supreme Court reflected this desire to protect men from women's accusations, calling them trivial and irresponsibly filed in the heat of the moment. This anxiety was shared by over 40% of the Lok Sabha, with many politicians believing that amendments to the existing laws need to be made so that innocent men are not dragged into jail based on false accusations. So let's look at the facts that are backing these claims. There have been some cases of men being wrongfully accused of sexual violence. And yes, on occasion, men and families have been wrongfully imprisoned under Section 498A on charges of taking dowry. But do these constitute the norm or majority of sexual or domestic violence cases? And do these make it sufficient for us to say that these laws are misused by women? Absolutely not. The perception that false cases form a majority of the rape and dowry charges filed is a myth, largely based on two sources. The first is a 2014 report showing that over 50% of rape charges filed in Delhi that year were false. The problem with that figure is, this report defined false charge as any rape charge that didn't go to trial, including ones where the complainant dropped the charge midway through the process. But a dropped charge is not the same thing as a false charge. In fact, in countries like the US and UK, which saw a similar dropout by complainants in rape cases in 2019, official state investigations found that women dropped charges due to intimidation and intense scrutiny by the police on their personal lives, not because their reports weren't true. Second, people argue women must be making false claims under Section 498A because only 12% of people charged under the dowry law are convicted, one of the lowest conviction rates of any criminal act in India. But there are many factors that can influence the outcome of a criminal trial, and cases of domestic violence and harassment are notoriously difficult to prove, especially if a victim is being intimidated or threatened by her family. Low conviction rates don't tell us anything about whether a claim is true or not. On the flip side, the official data from the National Crimes Records Bureau shows that the rate of false rape charges in India is only 8%. The National Family Health Survey shows that 1 out of 3 women suffer domestic violence in their marriages. Several independent studies have found that between 50 to 80% of Indian women have been subject to some form of public sexual harassment. So statistically, we know that most of these crimes go unreported and very few claims are made up. Then why do people still believe that women misuse these laws to target innocent men? It's because we've been socially conditioned to doubt women's complaints of abuse. Calling out women for falsely accusing men falls in line with a historical pattern of discrediting women's voices, making it hard for a woman who suffers abuse to be taken seriously. In a patriarchal society, power and prestige for families and communities often rests on the power and prestige of the current and future male heads of the household. A threat to a man's reputation is thus seen as a threat to an entire family and community's reputation, which is why all of us are more likely to doubt a woman's testimony and believe a man's innocence. And here's the thing. The Indian Penal Code and our criminal justice system are not perfect. But there's a difference between critiquing and asking for changes in the justice system and advocating for a misogynistic narrative that women are abusing loopholes in the system. the laws that protect women from abuse, harassment, and assault are a result of years of feminist activism. And there's still a long way to go before women are truly equal in the home and in the courts. Between now and then, the most important thing we can do is to believe women when they bravely speak up about the abuse they face in their families, and to make the entire system kinder and more supportive towards victims of these crimes. That's it for our latest video in the Overthinking It series. If you enjoy overthinking with us, please don't forget to like, share, subscribe to the Swaddle, and don't forget to hit that bell icon so you stay updated.